How did you do with this week's Excel challenge? Our expert, Claudia Buckley, has the solution. So, let's see how everyone did with their homework.
Sorting was probably the first data manipulation task you learned in Excel. But our challenge this time called for sorting a data set by multiple criteria, or multi-level sorting. We also needed to sort in an order that we defined, not alphabetically, numerically, or by day of the week. Excel already has those capabilities built in. We needed to create a custom list. So were you able to figure it out? Before we started, we had to set up the custom list. In Windows, it's tucked away in your Excel file menu. And it's under Options. Click Advanced on the left panel here and scroll down to General. Click Edit Custom List, and then you just enter the items in your list in the order that you'll want them sorted by. And use the return key to separate our list items. Then we press Add, and we can see that our custom list shows up here. Now it's available for our future Excel files. We can click OK, and OK to get out of these options. It's a lot easier to get to if you're using a Mac. Just go to Excel, click on Preferences, and then click Custom Lists. Then you'll just create your list in the same way as we just did. You can close that, and now we can get to work. We start by clicking anywhere within the dataset, going to the Data tab, and then clicking on the sort icon. This gives us a dialog box which allows multi-level sorting. We first want the towns to be together, shown alphabetically. So we'll want this sorted by town in the A to Z order. Within each town, we want schools to be sorted by type. So we add a level, and our second level sorting will be by type of school. And now is where we'll use the custom list we created. So this is the order in which we want our school sorted. We click OK. And we need to add a third level because we also want schools of the same type within the same town to show the school with the larger population first. So we add another level, population, and we want largest to smallest. Our data has headers, so that's already checked right here. And we're done with this task, so we click OK. Let's take a look at our data to make sure that it's displaying what we want. So each town is sorted alphabetically, and schools are sorted by the type of school within each town. So Collinsville has elementary, middle, then high school. Eastwood has elementary, middle, high, and college. And within Eastwood, we have two middle schools, and we're showing the one with the larger population first. So our data looks good. The second part of our task is to calculate and display the occupancy levels based on school types. We want to know what percentage of the capacity of each school type is being used within the school district. For that, we use the SUMIF function to extract only the school type that satisfies each criterion. So here we type equals SUMIF, open parenthesis, and the range that we want here is going to be in column B. To select the entire column all the way to the end, we can choose the first cell and then click Control, Shift, and the down arrow. And to make this an absolute reference, we just hit F4. We type a comma to move to our criteria, which will be the text here in H1. And the range that we want to add will be in this column, the population column. And again, to go to the end, Control, Shift, and down arrow. Make it absolute with F4. And that's the end of our SUMIF formula. This only tells us how many students are in elementary school. We want to know what's the percentage of the actual capacity. So we need to type slash to divide this by another SUMIF formula. This time, we're still looking at the range. Control shift down arrow. Make this absolute. Again, we want this for elementary students, but this time the range that we want to add is going to be in the capacity column. Select this to the end, make it absolute, close parenthesis, and enter. So elementary schools in this district are 94% occupied. And now we just need to copy this formula to the other cells. We're almost done. We just need to sort this horizontally from lowest to highest occupancy. Let's select this range because we don't want the text here to get sorted with our data. So let's sort this range horizontally. We click on the sort icon and we need to choose options here. We're sorting now not from top to bottom, but from left to right. Click OK. And we are sorting by the values in the second row. So we need to click row 2 here. And we do want this from smallest to largest values. So we click OK. And this tells us that our colleges and high schools are almost at capacity. So our job here is done. Sometimes you have a task that's so easy to do, but it's hard to remember how to do it because it isn't something you do every day. And that can be frustrating. So it's good to keep your skills sharp by testing yourself like this from time to time. See you for our next challenge.
So there it is. Did you get the same results? Did you use the same approach? Or did you try something different? We'd like to know. Share your take on the challenge in the comments below or join us for more discussion in our Slack channel. Link in the description. Thanks for participating and make sure to subscribe to this channel to get an alert when the next challenge is released. We'll see you then.